morning. Some eggnog here. I wasn't going to do this. I wasn't going to talk about this movie at all. And no, I haven't actually seen the movie, so I think it may be kind of unfair, but I've heard enough about it, and I've read the stuff on Wikipedia and all that, and I just need to talk about this because, in general, the idea is getting overused. So, when it was, you know, I hadn't seen the original Black Christmas until this year. And it's a good movie. It's pretty good. Go watch it. You know, I did a review. Watch my review for it. It's a very good movie. But when I did that review, I said I wasn't going to be reviewing the Black Christmas remake or the one that's coming out this year. And I'm not. This is not a review. Let's talk about Black Christmas 2019. You know, I'm going to try to go away with this because I'm not going to give it a rating or anything. I'm just going to talk about, you know, my feelings toward this movie and everything that's going on with this. Female empowerment has been a thing for years. I'm not against it by any means. But when you make a film specifically aimed at this cause of female empowerment, and you have the audacity to name it, to label it, Black Christmas. To try to capitalize on that. Capitalize on the name. That's what they're doing. So, I did that off. It's bugging me. Eggnog. So, put the Christmas stuff in the back. It's okay. It's good. Santa Claus.
That's all you're getting this Christmas.
That's basically what people are saying about, hey, what did you think of the new Black Christmas movie?
Was that on your list?
So back to when this was announced, the end of the summer, middle of the summer, sometime in the summer, this was announced, and you got, you know, a synopsis of what it was going to be like, about college girls being murdered by some man, but the girls are going to fight back and stand up to this, you know, this man. Right away, turned off. And then the trailers came out. I didn't watch the initial trailer because I was already turned off from it. I started seeing ads on TV, and right away, it looked terrible. And I said, I'm not going to go see that. I don't want anything to do with that movie. It looks terrible. I'm not going to go see a terrible movie. I made that mistake with Slender Man. I'm not going to do it again. So I haven't actually seen the movie. But I know enough about it from other people's reviews. The director of this directed a Thanksgiving episode of the Hulu series. I think it's Hulu. Into the Dark, where it's basically like Masters of Horror, where it's an anthology series and they do like little mini movies, you know, as episodes. And I guess to one of the YouTubers, I don't know if I can say his name, but Jason Smith, Sinister Cinema Reviews, according to him, it feels like an episode of that show. And it just labeled it Black Christmas, which most of the Hellraiser movies could be considered, you know, pieces from an anthology show, and they shoved Pinhead in there, and there you go, you know, especially Hellraiser Hellworld, which I admittedly is one of my favorites, just because it follows the campiness culture of the late 90s, you know, it's in early 2000s, and just, you know, it's got some good actors in it, I think. But here, I've seen like three reviews, and it's basically just, it's an agenda film, they have an agenda with this. Men are pigs, men are shit, they treat women like shit, And fuck men, women are better. Basically what this movie is saying. And yeah, I got that as soon as they said what the movie was about. I was like, no. Because one of my favorite Disney movies was ruined by the female empowerment message. Now, Disney has been doing the female empowerment thing for years with their Disney princesses. And that's fine. But it wasn't overly abundant. It wasn't overly, you know, shoved in your face like it was with the Aladdin remake. And what pissed me off so much about that movie was not because the female empowerment message was in it, but the fact that they shoved it so much in there in a time period where it just didn't exist yet. And then, like, so I was going to do a review on it, but things happened and December got canceled and yeah. But the Aladdin remake basically just became Jasmine because she basically saved the date in the end, even though they have Aladdin come back and do his whole trick Jafar into becoming a genie thing. They stopped the film towards the end for a song that wasn't in the original and it's all about female empowerment. I will not be silenced. I will be the one on top. I will be the queen. I will do this, you know, this, da 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 da. And, you know, she does eventually get silenced at the end, but they push her to the forefront, and she becomes the Sultan. That's the one thing that pissed me off, is that she becomes the Sultan. And she gets her way, and she gets the female empowerment message shoved down our throats. And you could say this started with Captain Marvel, fine, but the people are on a warpath. And yes, it's a female director, so there's that too. And this film is basically not even related to Black Christmas in any way. There's no Billy, there's no, you know, there's a college setting, and it's Christmas. That's it. There's no phone calls, for one, but there was just a jump scare call, where it's just like the girl's mom. They change it for a Scooby-Doo plot, basically, is that a professor and a fraternity are targeting these women at a sorority because this one of the women at the sorority was raped by one of the men in the fraternity. And they couldn't prove it, so he never got punished for it or anything, which, by the way, they stole that from Degrassi. Just saying. And so the fraternity is out for revenge for this girl for outing him, even though he didn't get in trouble for it. But she couldn't prove it, which was taken from Degrassi. I'm just saying. There's a plot point in one of the seasons where this happens. But and then they mix that in with the Scooby-Doo plot, where they had this bust of the founder of the college, I think it is, and this black goo is coming out of it, and the black goo is controlling these fraternity members to kill members of the sorority. Sounds like the Scooby-Doo movie to me. And right away, when I watched one of the reviews, I was just like, how is that Black Christmas? You know, I read the synopsis first. I was like, how is this Black Christmas? This is totally not the plot of Black Christmas. But it's a female empowerment movie. It's not just women. Now, horror doesn't need a female empowerment movie. For years, women have been getting out on top in horror films because of the Final Girl thing. So the fact that they need to have a movie about female empowerment in the horror genre is baffling. Because of the fact that it's always been the final girl. And while there are a couple, like Friday the 13th Part 6. Friday the 13th Part 4, 5, and 6, I guess. Friday the 13th franchise, and maybe even in the, you know, one or two in the Nightmare on Elm Street franchise. Maybe even in the, you know, Halloween franchise, you know, once in a while. where a man does survive as well as a woman, or sometimes by himself, it doesn't matter, because it's always the trope in horror films, right? In slasher films in general, is that it's the, you know, the final girl. And the original Black Christmas just was the final girl, even though she probably dead because the cops were stupid and didn't look in the fucking attic, but they searched everywhere else. So she's probably dead because they all left her, and now you better come down and eat me. Because the cops in that movie were stupid, except John Sackney's a badass. But if there's any genre out there that doesn't need female empowerment, it's horror. Because they have, you know, like I said, the final girl. So the fact that they need to make this movie about female empowerment in the horror genre is just... And it wouldn't be nothing if they just had... If they haven't fight back, that's fine. Because, like, Sorority Row did that. Where they fought back against this killer. But they were clearly going for female empowerment thing, and it doesn't need to happen. I'm not against it. But ever since Captain Marvel came out, even before that, Wonder Woman came out, and like, oh, they could do a female-led movie. Well, let's try to top that. Marvel tried to do it with Captain Marvel, which is, you know, Wonder Woman is a superior film there. But ever since Captain Marvel came out, everyone was like, yeah, we gotta push this female empowerment stuff. And we've been having female empowerments on TV, and in Aladdin, and in other movies, and it's just like... And here's the thing, Captain Marvel came out this year, so you could say it was probably Wonder Woman that was the catalyst, and everybody's trying to just copy off the other one. But I'm not against female empowerment by any means. You want to, you know, if you're a woman, you want to, go ahead, by all means do it. But don't shove it down our throats in movies that could have been better if you just taken that plot point out. Like Aladdin. Should have just been, let's talk about Aladdin 2019, because that was the first time, you know, I liked the movie Captain Marvel, it's fine. But Aladdin was the first movie that I was just like, no, this kind of thing is ruining the movies. It's you know, it ruined Aladdin 2019 for me, it ruined it. I was all up for it, I was, you know, Will Smith is a genie, and let's see, you know, I think Gabriel Iglesias should have been a better genie, but you know. But, he did a good job, and the actor played Aladdin did a good job. The actress played Jasmine, and I like her. She was good in the Power Rangers movie. So, yeah. You know. But then you got movies like Charlie's Angels, which I also knew was going to suck from the trailer. I didn't even go see that either. Because it's another female empowerment thing. And you could say, oh, no, it's not. Charlie's Angels has been like that. They cast... They cast Kristen Stewart, who is a lesbian or bisexual, whatever, as the lead. And there's all these rumors going around that, oh, she can't be a lesbian if she wants to be in a Marvel movie or something like that. And she's all high and mighty that she's out there representing girl power and you know, the LGBT community, which is fine. But... They cast her in the role is probably going to be a, you know, men are pigs kind of movie, which turned me off right away. I don't want to see that. I want to see a Charlie Angels movie. I don't want to see men are pigs, we rule type movie, which is why this turned me off too, because I don't want to see that. I want to see a movie about women kicking ass and not having an agenda shoved down my throat like, oh, we kicking ass. By the way, men suck. No, I don't want to see that, because I'm a man, and I don't want to be told I suck while watching a movie about women kicking ass, okay? Because it used to be women want equal rights, right? And now it's like, fuck, man, we want to be better than them, right? Where did that come from, you know? Like I said, I'm not against female empowerment to a point, as was not getting shoved down our throats, but I think that they need to, like, stop this in movies and just, you know, make regular movies, not make agenda movies. There are movies out there that are clearly pandering to a certain, you know, kind of viewer. And they need to stop. They just need to do a female empowerment movie, fine. But don't use it as a platform to shove stuff down our throat. What if Child's Play, the Child's Play remake, what if they use that and Andy's being chased after, but the mom? And instead of Andy being the one, the mom gets taken up with them, you know. And what if Andy is the one that gets kidnapped and hung up and the mom has to save the day? And she, you know, she tells off Shane, fuck you, Shane. And then she beats the doll, fuck you, doll, you male doll. And it's all about that. What would you have thought there? A female empowerment message in Child's Play? That's not what happened. Child's Play remake was pretty good. But I'm just saying, what if they did that? And there's all these talks about female versions of this and female versions of that. And it's just, stop it. Alright? Like, they did a female version of Bern Thompson in Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2014. Whoopi Goldberg, you cast it right. It works. Whoopi Goldberg did a great job. I'm a fan of Whoopi Goldberg's. Have been since I was a kid. Very good job. For what she was given, good job. But she wasn't in there being like, a man can't do my job. Fuck men. Or screw men, because this is a PG-13 movie. Screw men. Or women are better. Women can do better things, and men can. Look at me, I got a big job. Can a man do this job? No, they can't do this job. That's my Whoopi Goldberg impression, by the way. You know, she wasn't like, they didn't write her like that. They wrote her like a regular character. If you have a woman in a position of power, like being a boss or something, and you write them as a regular character and not as this symbol of female empowerment, it'll work better than if you try to write her as female empowerment, because it's going to ruin the movie. People are going to like, I didn't come to see this kind of movie. And, well, I can't really say about people who go to see this movie, because people who saw the trailers knew what kind of movie it was. So anyone who goes to see this movie knows what kind of movie they're going to see. So there's that. But this is getting kind of long, so I'm going to kind of sum it up here. Female empowerment in movies is not wrong. Do it if you want to, that's fine. I'm not against it by any means. Don't make it the entire purpose of your film. Don't try to shout down people's throats that men suck, fuck men. You know, don't do that. Because, you know, Charlie's Angels flopped. This flopped. You know, so obviously it's not working. Captain Marvel didn't get very favorable reviews. So obviously this isn't working, so you should tone it down a little bit. Okay? Well, I'm Scotty, and we've talked about it, so I'll see you later. Like, share, and subscribe, by the way. Bye-bye. Eggnog. Why does it do that?